for one. X equals 17 minus 4y. Y equals x minus 2. So those, both of these equations give us like choices. Either we can use this equation to substitute for x because x is this, you know, same as this, so we substitute for x in the other equation. Or this equation says y equals this, so we can use this and substitute it in for y in this equation. Either way, we're going to get the same answer, of course. So which way should we go? Should we substitute in for x or substitute in for y?
Substitute for y.
Substitute for y. Okay, so this equation tells us that y is the same as x minus 2, right? You remember that this y and this y, since we're looking for this solution, right? And there's probably just one of them. The other options are 0 and infinity. Probably just one of these solutions. And this solution here is going to have a y, and that y is going to be the same for both equations. Right? And since these y's are going to be the same, this y is the same as this y is x minus 2, so this y must also be equal to x minus 2. So we take out the y and replace it with x minus 2. Now y is x minus 2 instead. So x equals, what are we going to do now? Distribute 17 minus 4x plus 8. Let's combine like terms. 17 plus 8 is 25. 4x, let that 4x to both sides. 4x, 5x is equal to 25, and x equals 5. Dividing on both sides by 5. Now we know that x is 5. We can plug that in and figure out what y is. Y is equal to 5 minus 2, y equals 3. So the solution is?
5, 3, 5,
comma. Just for fun, why don't we just test it and see? How do we test and see if this is the solution? Kids?
You plug in the numbers?
Plug in the numbers. 5 for x, do the first equation here. 5 equals 17 minus 4 times y is 3. Is 5 equal to 17 minus 12?
Yes.
It is, so check. Now the second equation, y is 3. X is 5. This is a silly check. This is how we found 3 in the first place.
Yeah.
But it still works. 5 minus 2 is 3. So check. Number 3. X plus y equals 0. X minus 2y equals 6. Okay, so now we have a bad deal here, because neither one of these equations tells us x is something or y is something. So we have to rewrite either one, it's our choice, either one we want, so that one of them now says x equals or y equals, so we have something to substitute. And as I look at it, this would be easy to solve for x, this would be easy to solve for y, this would be easy to solve for x, this would not be so easy to solve for y. So I got like three really easy options, and I should probably take one of those. Anybody really passionate about any of those? Okay, sis.
What I did is just subtracted y from the top one.
Okay, so you got x equals negative y, because y minus y is 0, and 0 minus y is just minus y, negative y. So x is the same as negative y, so I can put negative y in place of x. Negative y minus 2y equals 6. Just took the x out, replaced it with its equal, negative y. Negative 3y equals 6, y equals negative 2, divided by negative 3 on both sides. If y is negative 2, then we can use this to find what x is. X equals negative, negative 2. X equals positive 2. 2, negative 2. Questions about those two? Pretty like straightforward. They just give you two equations. You can find the solution by substituting. Okay. after that. Word problem number 22. It's about a triangle. This is x degrees, this is also x degrees, so these are the same, so we call an isosceles triangle. Y degrees here.
Let's use angle, the isosceles triangle is 2.5 times the measure of the base angle.
So this angle is bigger, it's 2.5 times bigger than this angle here.
Two equations.
One equation we're going to write is based on knowledge that we should all have, that the problem doesn't give us. What's something that you know about the angles of the triangle? Joseph?
They always add up to 180 degrees.
So what kind of equation could we write using that information? They all add up. If you add them all up, you get 180. Sean?
Y plus X plus X equals 180.
Johnny?
Y plus 2X.
Sure, you can put those two X's together and get Y plus 2x equals 180. Okay? So that's just based on common knowledge about triangles. It also says what's the obtuse angle?
Greater than 90.
Greater than 90. Which of these angles? What's the only angle that could possibly be obtuse?
Y.
Yeah, why? How come x couldn't be obtuse?
Because it's less than 90.
Yeah, well, how do you know it's less than 90? It's got to be less.
Because it's not a
smudge
straight.
It's not a triangle.
Yeah,
you can't just trust
a
picture.
It's 2x's
if you
see
them. Why is 2 obtuse angles would, if you had anything greater than 90 twice, then it already equal 180. So you can't have 390 degrees.
Even if this were just 90 and not more than 90, which is what obtuse is, if it were just 90, this would be 90, and since this is x also, this would have to be 90. That's already 180, which means this would have to be 0 degrees. Which you can't have a triangle. I mean, I guess you could. Okay, here's the angle x, and it's 90 degrees. Okay? And this is 0 degrees, so actually this would just be right on the same line. So really, I shouldn't have drawn that side. It's like a straight line. It's silly. Forget it. And it's obtuse. Besides that, it's obtuse, so it has to be more than 90. So these two together would already be more than 180, which means this would have to be a negative. This is silly. This is not going to work. Okay? So this is the only one that could be obtuse. All right. Obtuse angle is 2.5 times the measure of one of the base angles. What's the base angle called?
X.
Right. What's the obtuse angle called?
Y.
And it says that the obtuse is 2.5 times one of the base angles. What's the obtuse called again?
Y.
Y is
equals to y equals 1.5x.
2.5 times the base angle. It's saying it right to you. It's just telling you what the equation is supposed to be. Y, the obtuse angle, is equals 2.5 times the base angle, 2.5 times x. There it is. There's your second equation. Y equals 2.5x. This is just, you cleaned it up a little bit. Right, do we have something to substitute?
What equals 2.5x for y?
So 2.5x plus 2x equals 180. 4.5x equals 180. Divide by 4.5. You got me. So now we know this is 40 degrees. This is 40 degrees. And this is 2.5 times bigger, right? So we just need to do 40 times 2.5, which would be 40.5 of that. This is exactly 100. Well, it's add up to 180, right? That's probably the easy way to think about it. 100 plus 40 plus 40, 180. All right. Give up on word problems, just because there's words there.
do that. Perfectly capable. Require some staring and thinking and mulling over. Let's pass those in.
Alright, so these both need, like both of these systems, need to be kind of set up. They're not quite set up for us to use substitution yet, you know what I mean? I mean, none of the equations here say y equals or x equals. Right? And just to be clear, I'm not doing anything with this one yet. I'm just observing something about it. Okay, let's start with this one. This one needs us to, you know, make it work. And we've got a little bit of a choice here. Grady, what do you choose?
I want to just did minus 2y on the top one.
Personally, how'd you make that decision? Why did you decide to do that as opposed to maybe working this equation?
Because it's positive.
Positive x, right? You can see into the future a little bit, right? And you know that it's when you solve this for x, it's going to be minus. So we're going to have x equals negative 2y minus 11. And OK, that's the better version of that first equation. And we can forget about that first version of it. OK, so that sets it up so we can what, Johnny?
Put negative 2y minus 11 in the x bar 2y minus 11.
All right. 2 times x, which the new x is negative 2y minus 11. Before I move on, okay, this is like, I don't know, the 10th or 12th time that I've substituted something in for something else. Okay, are there any concerns or questions, confusion about that step? Anything at all? Why did we do that? How did you know you're supposed to do that? How come there's no more x left? I mean, why is it gone? Any questions at all?
I'm just kind of confused on how to do it all.
Okay, well, aside from the first step of getting x by itself, notice that the first part, okay, is that we are going to replace this x right here, with something. Okay? Now, the only way that you can replace x with something is to replace it with something that's the same as x. You can't replace it with something that's different. Okay. For instance, if I told you that x was 3, you can put 3 in there. Right? X is 3, put 3 in there, and figure out what y is. Correct?
Yes.
I told you that x was negative 5. OK, let's put negative 5 in there and figure out what y is. Right? But I can't do that, or I haven't done that. I haven't told you that x is 3 or x is negative 5. But this equation does tell us that x is the same as negative 2y minus 11. Okay. It's kind of like you owe somebody $10, but you don't have $10. But you give them something that's the same as $10, like worth $10, at least to them. Does that make sense? They're not. It's not $10. It's not x, right? But it's the same as x. These two, this x and this negative 2y minus 11, they're the same as each other. They're interchangeable, right? It's like a word that means the same thing as another word. Like if I said the sentence, I have to think of synonyms. I don't know, let's try like I ran to the bathroom. Okay? Well, can we agree that bathroom and restroom, they agree they're the same thing? They mean the same thing? They're not the same word, because they're made with different letters. But do they mean the same thing? Okay. Or lavatory, or toilet. What?
Oval office.
Okay, now we're getting a little bit funny. Bathroom and restroom, though, same thing. If I say bathroom to you and I say restroom to you, they conjure the same things, right? So if I substitute, right, take bathroom out, and I say, I ran to the restroom. Has this sentence really changed?
No.
Okay, so it's the same as, it is with substitution of variables for other variables, right? This expression is the same as x, just like bathroom and restroom were the same. So I take out the x, like I took out bathroom from that sentence, and replace it with negative 2y minus 11, just like I replaced bathroom with the restroom. It's the same. How do I know it's the same? Since x. Because. Because that equation says it is. Okay? Yeah, they're equal because that equation says they're equal. So I take out the word x and I replace it with the word -2y minus 11. Okay? But it's the same. It's the same thing. How's that stretch out? Does that help? Okay, cool. So we just took out x and replaced it with something that's the same as x. And now we'll distribute the two. We get -4y. Minus 22 minus y equals 13. -4y minus 22 minus y equals 13. -4y minus y is -5y. And there's a minus 22 equals 13. We're going to add 22 on both sides. Add 22 on both sides, and we get 35. Is that right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Maybe I'm having a lapse in memory here. Oh, I think I'm thinking about the other one. Okay. So divide by -5 and y is -7. Okay, y is -7, so I'm just gonna go back. You'll notice this pattern every time you do substitution. The equation you use for substituting in, you can use now for figuring out what the other variable is. So x equals -2 times -7 minus 11. X equals 14 minus 11. X equals 3. So the solution, 3, -7. I'm going to do this equation now. The big hint was to solve this for X. All right, so I'll take this equation, I'm going to solve it for x. Not as easy as solving for x in this equation, but the idea is the same. How am I going to get x by itself? Somebody besides Johnny? And then I'm just doing all my guy.
So
trapped.
Okay.
Okay.
Subtract
8y to x equals -2 minus 8y. Almost done. John?
Divide by 2.
Divide by 2 on both sides, divide this by 2, you get right, 2 divided by, negative 2 divided by 2 is negative 1, negative 8 divided by 2 is negative 4, you get negative 1 minus 4, 1. Well, now we are in the same position we were before. We've changed this equation to this equation. Okay, much more useful to us because now we know that x is the same as negative y minus 4, or negative 1 minus 4y. Okay. So we are going to take out this x, just like we took out the word bathroom from that earlier sentence. We're going to replace it with something that's exactly the same as x. Okay, multiply by 3, distributing there. Negative 3 minus 12y plus 5y equals negative 10. Negative 3, negative 12y plus 5y is negative 7. 10, add 3 to both sides, negative 7, y equals negative 7, and y equals a positive 1. And if y equals a positive 1, then we can replace this y with a positive 1 and certainly figure out what x is. You know, let's do it in our heads, right? Negative 1 minus 4 times 1, negative 4 times 4, negative 4. Negative 1 minus 4,
five.
Negative 5. Negative 5 for x, 1 for y. Questions? Do you feel closer to being experts now? Feel like really good amateurs?
Make a couple of mistakes.
Making little mistakes, amateurs make a lot of mistakes. Experts make far fewer mistakes. Okay. Okay, let me put a challenge to you. Now all your answers may be different from each other. Okay? They could all still do exactly what I'm asking. Write a system of equations that has this solution. Give that some thought. You know what the solution is supposed to do in the system? It's really easy. Like, once you think about what the solution is supposed to do in both equations, you can make that solution do what it's supposed to do. So give that a shot. What is the solution to a system supposed to do? I don't want systems yet. I just want to give everybody something to think about. What's the solution to a system of equations supposed to do? Josie, can you
make both equations true.
Both equations true. So let me just suggest that you write two equations that look like this. Something times x plus something times y equals something. And the second equation, a lot different. Something times x plus something times y equals something. A lot of systems have looked that way. The thing is, you know, what do you know about these systems, the solution of the system?
Solution.
So what does this tell you about both of these systems, or both of these equations? What's this supposed to be?
X is supposed to be 4 and 5 is supposed to be 5.
Y is supposed to be 4. Does it matter what you make these numbers?
As long as
it comes out true. Can I just conceivably throw just random numbers in there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because I haven't decided what this is yet. So if x is 4 and y is 5, can't I just write this to be what it would have to be?
Yeah.
All right, so if x was 4, this would be 12. If y was 5, this would be 20. 20 plus 12 is
32.
I can just throw anything random in there. As long as it's not the same as these numbers, that would be kind of silly. How about negative 2 and 6? No reason why I can't. Negative 2 times 6, right, is negative 8. And 6 times 5 is 30. So negative 8 plus 30? Do we have two systems, or two equations?
Yeah.
Is the solution that works in both of them 4 comma 5? But now you see how I write these questions for the homework review. Pick a solution, write random coefficients, just write the answers that I'm supposed to get over on the right side. I have a system for you guys to solve. All right, you did great. No homework today.